Good morning, students. Welcome to the online classes. In this year also, like last year, because of the COVID-19 pandemic situation, we started the school, but after a few days of classes, according to the government instruction, we shut down the school. So because of that, again we are going to have the online classes. So without delaying, let us start the chapter one, students. From this chapter, already few topics already discussed in the classes, but in that class quite many of the students did not attend, might be because of several reasons. So let us start from the beginning so that the students will get the benefit, those who are not able to attend in the offline classes. Okay, so in this chapter, the name of the chapter is Evolution and History of Computers. So today, or the today's life, actually it is very hard to imagine without the computers. The computers, actually it has made a strong impact in our society. How? Like computers find application in many areas, business, health, telecommunication, engineering, entertainment, education, to home. It is only few names it has told, but it is very difficult to be say that in which field or in which area we are not using the computer. It is really difficult to be find. Almost in all the field or areas we are using the computers. Some example already has given, at home also using, agriculture also, telecommunications, science and technology, many areas. To fully understand computers and their impact on our day-to-day lives, it is important to understand their evolution. If you want to fully understand about the computers and their impact on our day-to-day life, no, how it has started, evolution started, then it has at present it is known as the computers. So for that, we need to know the evolution of computers. The development of computers from the early calculating devices to the present day computers can be broadly classified into following categories. To know about the development of the computers till the present day computers, it has divided into three categories. The first is mechanical calculating devices, electromechanical calculating devices, and electronic computers. So we will discuss each of these categories separate. We will discuss it so that we will know about the evolution. The first one is mechanical calculating devices. This is the one. So mechanical calculating devices can be further classified into manual calculating devices and semi-automatic calculating devices. So mechanical calculating devices also divided into two categories. One is manual calculating and semi-automatic calculating devices. So manual calculating devices, Napier, Abacus, and Napier bones are examples of manual calculating devices. Abacus. The development of this calculating device can be traced back to the ancient counting boards used in Mesopotamia around 3500 BC. These counting boards consisted of pitted boards with pebbles or beads, which were used for performing calculations. The modern abacus probably originated in the 15th century China. It consists of a rectangular frame carrying a number of rods or wires. The rods have beads and can be moved along the rods, which are used for performing calculation. This is the abacus. This is the one, abacus. These are called pebbles or beads. and it is fitted on the rod. And this has two separate parts. One is this part and that is this part. These two separate part. And when it has introduced or revolution started 3500 before Christ. And the modern abacus probably originated when? In the 18th century. In where? In China. Okay. Now, modern abacus are found in different form. That is, one is Chinese abacus, Japanese abacus, which is known as Sorobon. Then Russian abacus, which is known as Scotty. An abacus is used to do simple calculations, addition, subtraction, multiplication and division. So mainly in the beginning stage, abacus was introduced for calculation only. So in the first stage, we can say the computer is known as calculating device. For only for calculation purpose only it has introduced. So it was known as calculating device. After introducing the abacus, next Napier bones. This calculating device was invented by Scottish Napiers. Scottish mathematician Sir John Napier in the 17th century. Napier bones are number rods that can be used for multiplying a long number by a single digit number. Each rod divided into 10 squares. The top square has a digit with the multiplication table of that digit written vertically downwards. A digit of the multiplication table are split by a diagonal line. A special rod having the digit pointing vertically downwards was used to represent the multiplier. Now, these numbers, this is the number these are the numbers, but it will multiply vertically with this. Now let us see by multiplying this one to this one. 1 1 is 1. This is the 1 1 is 1. Then this 2 1 is 2. Then 3 1 is 3. Yeah. For example, 7 5s are 7 5s are 35. 7 5s are 35. So this way this table is working. This table, this type of table, not exact Napier bones, but almost like this table already you have learned in primary level. And even at present, quite many of the notebooks also have provided this table. When you buy the new notebooks from the bazaar and all backside, you can see like this table has provided. for calculation purpose. So Napier Wounds was introduced or developed by who? Sir John Napier. And when? In 17th century. The next is semi-automatic calculating device. Semi-automatic calculating device. Pascaline Staffelwalsch. So before started the semi-automatic calculating device, just a recall of that manual calculating device. So at the beginning, computers are started as calculating device manually with abacus and Napier Wounds. With abacus, with this abacus and Napier Wounds, this Napier Wounds, with this it was started. Then it was introduced semi-automatic, means the mechanical things, mechanical devices introduced. That's why the first category it is divided into two parts, manual and semi-automatic. So in semi-automatic calculating device, in semi-automatic calculating device, Pascaline, Staffelwalsch, Jacquard loom, difference engine, analytical engine, are some examples of semi-automatic calculating device. Pascaline adding machine, or Pascal's adding machine, or Pascaline, in 1641, it has introduced one of the first semi-automatic calculating devices. The Pascaline was developed by Blaise Pascal. This brass rectangular box had 8 movable dials to add sum up to 8 digits long. This is Pascaline, and these are the dialer. These are dialer where we can add only for addition purpose, add sum up to 8 digits long. So on the dialer, numbers are there like a old type of telephone, landline telephone, where we are dialing and the you need to rotate the number from left to right side. Yeah. Clockwise we have to be rotated. Also with that, through that only in Pascaline we can add it. Here in Pascaline, here we dial and the dialer number will display in this area. I'll show you here again nicely. Here we dial and it will display in this area. Okay, in this area, here your small boxes are there. Here is again small boxes. There it will display. So accordingly it will add and display there. So it is semi-automatic, means in manual calculating device we'll apply the method and you need to calculate by ourselves. We have to make use of our brain and we have to calculate within our brain itself. But in next step in semi-automatic, what happened? Only question of giving the input, the calculation will do by the calculating device. Okay, so in the first stage manually we need to do everything, but for that methods are there to calculate faster and all. And in the second step, what happened? Semi-automatic devices introduces only we need to give input, output automatically get it. Okay, the next, the Staffelwalsch, the step reckoner, step reckoner in 1672 it was introduced. Who introduced? The German mathematician and the philosopher Gottfried Wilhelm von Leibniz developed the Staffelwalsch. So in the semi-automatic device, Pascaline has introduced the calculating device where all you need to give input and output will get automatically. And that Pascaling device is introduced only for addition, that also up to 8-digit long. Then Staplewards, he has introduced and developed another device which is called Staplewards, and or it is called, it is also called Labinus machine, which has developed for doing addition, subtraction, multiplication and division. So all the features are there, all the calculation which manually we are doing, those things automatically you can do it. After the Jacquard loom in 1801, Joseph Jacquard devised a mechanical loom called Jacquard's loom and also developed a punch card, a means of controlling the loom, which made weaving complex pattern a lot easier. The device used instructions stored on a punch card to control the movement of threads. So Jacquard loom, he has introduces this mechanical this which is called loom, Jacquard loom, and he also developed one punch card, and that punch card has introduces or developed mainly for to control that loom, mainly for what purpose? For made weaving complex. Here weaving means here the girls that weaving on their shalwar kameez and all that, the designs are there with the thread and all, they have made flower with many colors and all this threading, sorry, the weaving it is called. So those weaving complex things manually when you do takes time, but with the machine when you do it is complex. Actually machine need to get a perfect instruction to pick the colors of the thread and all. So to control that, this punch card is used to make complex pattern easier a lot for that purpose only. So the device used instructions stored on the punch card and control the movement of the threads. So easily it can movement of the threads, it can be easily control it. So for those purpose only this Jacquard loom punch card has introduced. Okay, so now in semi-automatic calculating device, these few are there, and after that next is difference engine. After the Jacquard of difference engine, and from there only the evolution started, the present day computers idea or ideology got from the next topic, which is difference engine, and that we will discuss on the next class. So in this topic, the first is mechanical calculating device. That mechanical also divided into or classified into or two categories. One is manual calculating and semi-automatic calculating. A manual computer, actually it is called a calculating device. At present it has multitasking work can do, that's why it is developed and given, is known as the computer. And so manual calculating device, Abacus and Napier bones, and the manual you need to do, and the calculation also, everything you need to do manually. But later on what happens, semi calculating automatic calculating device introduces, where you need to just give the input and output will get automatically. Okay, so from this chapter I am giving you some homework, and you need to be write it down and send through the WhatsApp in the group. So first question, the first question is, mechanical calculating devices classified into how many categories. Second question. Abacus is used for what purpose? What is Sorobon? Third question. What is Sorobon? Fourth question. What is Scotty? Fifth question. Who invented the Napier bones and when? Next question, who invented the Pascaline and when? Next, who invented the Staple valve and when? Next, who invented the Jacquard looms and when? So students, today up to this, we are going to have the classes on next topic on the next day of class. With this, today, bye bye.